Good evening and welcome to Waltham, Massachusetts for tonight's Northeast 10 Conference women's basketball semifinal game featuring Bentley University taking on Franklin Pierce, a rematch of last year's championship game.
Rotation stepping up, swatting that shot away and getting possession for her team.
Cowan could look for three straight away. Got another one. Second tray for Lakia Cowan. Franklin Pierce leads by 11, and we have a timeout called again by Barbara Stevens.
All right, you got off to a great start, 17-6 early on. I thought your kids played with tremendous energy early on. You said you haven't led too many times at halftime. You didn't think you'd be talking to me first. What's been the difference for your group so far?
Not in this gym, anyway. I thought we played excellent defense for 7 or 8 minutes of the game. You know, we made some shots. We took care of the ball, and we made some shots. I thought we were moving very aggressively offensively. We were attacking. But I like our defense.
Broken by Franklin Pierce. McDonald, nice bounce feed inside for White. It's just taken right away by the alert Courtney Finn.
Great job by Finn. And again, partner, we talked about White bringing the ball down low, as she tends to do. Finn recognizing that and stealing it away.
Great catch by Batista and finish. Not sure how she, A, caught the ball, and B, got it in there.
Nice. Good pump fake, and now Franklin Pierce back to the matchup zone and immediately generates a steal.
McDonald bounce pass cross court for Johnson, who just about manages to pull it in the corner.
Wow, that ball was nearly out of bounds. As close as you can get without it touching any part of the line.
Two-player game. Cowan trying to find an angle for White. Out of the top for Johnson. Brugler working hard to deny an entry pass. Shot clock down to 7. Sab works one-on-one against Finn. Tries to power her way in. Puts it off the window and in.
Wow.
Tie game again.
How about that? Out of the timeout court. Quick point.
Roberson off a screen. Back to Crowell. Straightaway 3 over White.
Got it!
Well, that rolled around and did not want to go, but it finally dropped. Franklin Pierce with no timeouts. Come back to the other end for a final shot. Sab a runner off the iron. We've got overtime at the Dana Center. Crowell, where she just made that big 3. In the corner, it's Goodwin. She'll try to make a shot for once, and does. After a miserable shooting day, Catherine Goodwin finally makes the 3.
Second half in overtime. They've struggled to score it mightily.
Let's see what Steve Hancock drew up. Cowan, right side, fakes for 3, steps back and launches the tray. Can't get it to go. Weak side rebound by Sab. Sends it out for Johnson. She fires for 3 and got it with 23 seconds to go. Johnson right on her, and Albacola, shot clock at 6. Batista pump fake. Crowell in the corner, has to take the 3 to beat the shot clock, and rattles it home. Oh, she's hit a couple of big 3s today. Seconds ago, that'll do it, but shot clock went off. But it really is academic, just a matter of what the final score is. Martell makes the 3.
Head coach Barb Stevens and junior Kaylee Crowell. Coach, I'll start with you. I got a happy young lady to your right. I ask how your night was. It was a struggle tonight, certainly for your team, but you got through it. Talk about this performance in this game.
I think I'll give Franklin Pierce a tremendous amount of credit. They came in here ready to win. I mean, they came out blazing and, caught us off guard, put us on our heels. But I'll give our kids so much credit. They fought back. And then this one to my right is just, we'll call her Miss Clutch tonight.
You struggled mightily to score the ball the first half and certainly throughout, but your defense really kept you in the game. I felt like in the second half, your defensive intensity even reached a different level. You went about 7 minutes without a point, yet only trailed by 2 or 4 at that juncture. You hung in there. Talk about your defensive effort, because what I've heard from everyone about this team is that it's a good Bentley team, but their defensive energy and their intensity is different this year. Talk about that.
Yeah, I think that that's true. Our defense has kept us in a lot of games, this one in particular. We were struggling. We couldn't, number one, we couldn't make a shot. Right. And then number two, we weren't getting good shots either. So I think that the issue became, we had to really suck it up and defend in the second half. And we knew in the beginning of the game we were just terrible. So we just said at halftime, look, we've got to defend. Otherwise, this team's going to run away with it. And we did. We defended.
I know it's hard to think about right now, but you'll take the court Sunday afternoon where you'll play host to second seed of Southern Connecticut. They were life and death to win. They won by 1 tonight as well in another very close game, as both of our women's semifinals came right down to the wire. They've had your numbers so far this year, but yet you get the opportunity to host this championship. Give us a little look ahead to that.
I haven't really thought about anything other than beating Franklin Pierce and trying to prepare for them. I don't think anybody on our team has really thought ahead, but we'll take a few minutes to unwind from this, and then we'll take a peek at Southern Connecticut. And you're right, they were great here. They were great. And you talk about a team that defends. Now they defend. So you know, we're going to have to figure out a way to score some points against them.
I know it wasn't the most aesthetically pleasing game, but yet your team showed a lot of heart. Congratulations on the victory.
They did. Thank you very much.
We'll see you Sunday afternoon.
You're welcome.
Right. I'll speak to this young lady now, Kelly Kroll. First of all, congratulations. It had to feel pretty good for you.
Yeah, it did. It did.
You're a young lady who transferred here. You've had a number of injuries. It's been very frustrating for you, I know. Yet you've battled, you've grinded, you've found a way back on the floor. I can't say because I haven't seen all your games, but I had to imagine this was a pretty special moment for you tonight.
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely a special moment. I was nervous, like, very nervous, but I was like, all right, it's okay, calm down. So, I mean, it was special.
Talk to me about the shot that first sent the game into overtime. It looked like it hit the glass a little bit first, and I'm not sure that's what you intended,
yeah.
Yet it went down. Out of the timeout, you needed the three. What was the conversation like?
We just basically set up a play, and I was supposed to get the shot, and I just knew that if I didn't make the shot, then it was done, so I just shot it and hoped to win it.
What does that say to you, that your coach has the confidence in you to draw that play out for you in that situation, knowing that you need a three to send the game into the overtime?
I mean, it's definitely, it feels special when she, like, counts on me, but it's also a lot of pressure because I knew, and my other teammates could do it too, so, but, yeah.
All right, now walk me through the shot in overtime, which really was the final nail in the coffin. It gave you a 7-point lead. You would never give up. Shot clock winding down. It seemed like 2-1. You got to throw it up there, and somehow it found a way home. Was that the thinking?
Yeah, pretty much.
In terms of this team, obviously you getting back out there and contributing. For you personally, what's this mean?
For me to get out back? It means, like, everything. I love my teammates and my team and my coaches. So just to be on the floor with them, it's like means everything to me.
Kaylee, congratulations. We'll see you Sunday.
Thank you.
Very welcome. Kaylee Crowley, happy Falcon player.